Hey Measuring Hero, Jay here. Today we thought we'd come all the way out to Milan to do a profile of the company Lasertech. But it is really loud here because, as you can see, they're busy working. So let's go into the office and meet them where it's quieter.
Do you want to come? Want to come? You sit down there. So, in order to learn a little bit more about Lasertech, we brought in Paolo to tell us more about Lasertech.
Yes, thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for your time.
First, welcome here in our new factory. We are here since 1 month. Because this factory is a really new one. We moved the other two facilities we had before into this new building. Lasertech is active in chemical etching and laser cut. We started in 1970.
So, 1970, wow.
Yes, it is 51 years today. And we started at the beginning mainly in electromechanics.
Okay.
When there was a first telephone, you know, the dial phone, when you have to turn the disc and not the digit.
I remember that, yeah. But maybe some don't.
It was quite a long time ago. And we are really proud because this is a really, really new factory. It represents really the state of the art of technology for production. And we move here to develop much more in volume and quality and so on for our main business. So our main business, it is automotive, it is electronic, it is medical, it is fashion and luxury.
Oh, wow.
And we need really something new and well-organized to cover the needs of our customer.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, when you, I mean, that's quite a breath. I mean, from medical, that's highly regulated, to luxury eyeglasses that they must be very taxing customers in very different ways.
Yes, there are completely different approach. In medical and automotive, everything is measurement, everything must be tolerance, must be perfect and so on. In other field of application as luxury and fashion and so, it's much more, must be beautiful, must be perfect, no spot, no scratch. I want something different. It is more immaterial.
Wow.
So we have to jump quickly from really material production as medical, so surgical blades, implants, everything that need to be regulated and to be measured and so on, to, must be beautiful. Yes, but what is beautiful for you? So are really two different worlds, but we have to kind of get together into the same process and the same factory.
I'm really fascinated to hear how you dance that between function and form and marry that. Now, to be honest with you, I know very little about the chemical etching manufacturing process. Can you actually bring us through this process?
Absolutely,
how it's accomplished?
Absolutely. So we start from the raw material.
Okay.
The first, it is the selection of the raw material.
Okay.
In this case, it is high glossy, high polishing material, really for luxury items and need to take care of the surface.
Yeah.
After that, we have to clean it, because material comes from production. So it contains dearness, it contains, as you can see on the backside, also our beautiful fingerprints that we have to remove before the process.
Yeah.
So we clean it, we cover with the special film.
Okay.
This plastic film is like a camera film. It's sensitive to the light.
Okay.
So we use a special laser system to scan the surface and transfer the geometry, the design on what we had to do. After that, we remove the plastic film where it is not polymerized by the laser, and we spray a special chemistry, an acid, that will dissolve the metal into the final shape.
Okay, and then when you manufacture something in this process, what type of tolerances can you achieve doing it this way?
We are in the field of microns.
Wow.
The best we can do it is usually 10 microns.
10 microns?
Yes, yes. It's really, really precise, really effective process. We are usually in the range as average of 50 microns.
Sure.
So we need also, after process, a lot of inspection, a lot of measurement, a lot of control, because during the process, we cannot touch the product. We can just check something to see if we are in the range of what is expected by the customer.
But you won't know till it's over.
Yes.
Yeah.
When we have the finished product in hand, we have to measure and see if it is okay or not okay.
Sure.
And sometimes it is for a few microns.
Right, right. So final inspection is extremely important for your business because there's no way to check and
process.
Yes,
because if we touch the produce during the step of production, we damage.
Right.
And so we really need some special target over the process to see if we are, as I told you, in the range and are those holes around that give us just a sensation, this hole is okay or not okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But what is the part? Right. We can measure just at the end.
So final inspection is extremely important for your...
Yes, absolutely, customers. Because without final inspection, we cannot be sure that the parts are okay or not okay. It is a really, really complicated process.
Absolutely. Can we see that?
Absolutely.
Great.
You are welcome. Come
All
on.
Right, thank you.
So let's go. We are going to the design engineering department. That is the really first step of production, where we got the drawings of the customer. And we use the domain of the customer to generate the data we need for production, but finally the data we need for the final inspection.
Okay, okay.
Because really, the start and the end need to be generated at the same time at the beginning of the process.
Great, great. Let's have a look.
So we were at the start of the process. We saw the engineering department, the CAD design, where we generate the data for production, but finally we generate the data for the final inspection. So here it is when the end of the process, where we have to measure everything and be sure that everything is fine with intolerance.
Okay. And we really appreciate that you have trusted ZEISS with the inspection of that. I mean, we are honored that you chose us to represent quality for your company.
No, absolutely. We are really happy about the machine. It was possible to do a lot of things and to improve also our quality and service to customer.
And I also appreciate the fact that you opened your home to us, let us learn more about Lasertech and what you do. Maybe sometime when we come back to Milan, we can come back.
Absolutely. You are welcome. You will be welcome anytime you want to be here.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paolo. And with you out there, hope you enjoyed this little tour. Don't forget to stay safe and stay healthy. We'll see you next Thursday.